Do you know that there is an indication that pelvic floor muscle training is effective for men with erectile dysfunction and premature ejaculation? Do you want to know more about this? Continue watching this video. Hello, I'm Heidi Moussor from Pelvic News Channel. This is the channel for all professionals who are interested in the pelvic region and want to learn about the latest scientific research and news and connect with colleagues. Do you like this channel? Please hit the notification bell down below and you'll get a notification as soon as I upload new videos. You can also subscribe to my blog at pelvicnewschannel.com and you'll get a notification in your email as well. Years ago, I read this book from Craig Dory on erectile dysfunction in men. And this book describes anatomy, physiology, the diagnosis, treatment, risk factors of men with erectile dysfunction. And in this book, an extensive trial they did on this subject is described, quite extensively. But as one trial is not sound evidence, I was really pleased to see that a systematic review was published recently on erectile dysfunction and premature ejaculation in men. And today, I want to discuss this systematic review with you and the clinical implications. The definition of erectile dysfunction is the complaint of inability to achieve and sustain an erection firm enough for the satisfactory sexual performance. And the definition of premature ejaculation is the complaint of a persistent or recurrent pattern of too rapid achievement of ejaculation during partnered sexual activity, so before the individual wishes it. These definitions are both from ICS. So both erectile dysfunction and premature ejaculation are highly prevalent in men. There are many risk factors that can contribute to these complaints, like hormonal, vascular, neurological, or psychological problems. It's also well known in men with diabetes mellitus, and the use of certain drugs can have a negative impact as well. And the treatment generally consists of lifestyle modifications, vacuum devices, psychotherapy, and the use of medication. However, the pelvic floor muscles might also play an important part. The ischiocavernosus muscle helps to increase the intracavernous pressure and influence penile rigidity. And the bulbocavernosus muscle and the levator ani muscle help to propel the semen through the urethra, thus the ejaculation, by rhythmic contractions. So if there's an underlying pelvic floor dysfunction, pelvic floor muscle treatment might be a very good treatment option. And the systematic review I'm going to discuss today included all studies on erectile dysfunction and premature ejaculation reported up to January 2018, and all quantitative studies, of course. And the men had to be 18 years or older, all men with neurological conditions or who had pelvic surgery, urological surgery, or had neurological problems were excluded. The main outcome measure used for erectile function is the International Index for Erectile Function, and for premature ejaculation, the intravaginal ejaculatory latency time. Of the 254 studies they found, 10 were included in the review, 5 on erectile dysfunction and 5 on premature ejaculation. And there was one randomized control trial for erectile dysfunction and one for premature ejaculation. And other study designs were pre, post, or for instance retrospective. All the studies on erectile dysfunction gave the same intensity of pelvic floor muscle training. However, there was quite some difference between the studies because some added electrical stimulation and others added biofeedback. Another big difference was the number of sessions given. Some only gave 5 sessions and others 20 sessions in a 3 to 4 month period. And all treatment schedules gave home exercises as well. The cure rates reported were between 35% and 47%. All studies reporting on premature ejaculation used electrical stimulation with pelvic floor muscle training, and some used biofeedback as well. In total, the number of sessions given were between 12 and 20, and they were given in a period of 4 weeks to 3 months. In only one study, men got home exercises as well. The cure rates reported were between 55 and 83%, and 3 studies reported a significant increase in intravaginal ejaculatory latency time. Well, I think that this systematic review shows that there are definitely indications that pelvic floor muscle treatment can be a good treatment option for men. However, due to the heterogeneity of the studies with electrical stimulation, biofeedback, pelvic floor muscle training, it's really important that more randomized controlled trials are performed and that those trials report on the training schedules, how electrostimulation is performed, etc. And this is a topic I've discussed in a previous video and blog as well. And I would also like to recommend to do a full pelvic floor muscle investigation. Because if you don't do a proper investigation of the pelvic floor muscles, you don't know if there's anything to treat. And I think pelvic floor muscle training is definitely not for all men. As erectile dysfunction and premature ejaculation can have multiple causes, good patient selection is important. And if pathology is ruled out, pelvic floor muscle training might be a good first-line treatment option. In this video, I've only discussed certain parts of the systematic review. So if you want to learn all the ins and outs of the review, you should read the full article. In the description below, I'll put the details. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel. And I hope to see you next time.